just dream that? Did I really see that? Were you really there with me? Or what did we just feel? Om Shiva, Shri Shakti, Shivoham, Shaktyoham. How can I know that? How can we always see that? Could we really go back there? Is it with us everywhere? Om Shiva, Shri Shakti, Shivoham, Shaktyoham.
Baba teaches us a new language, the language of wordlessness, the language of absence of sound. This is the divine language, silence. One has to try so hard to learn a new language. Grammar rules, meaning of words, their pronunciations, accent, dictionary, writing practice, speaking practice, and the words have got so many diverse meanings, sometimes diametrically opposite. We exert so much to learn new language. Have we taken that much effort in learning the language of silence? This is also a language, a divine language. And the beauty of the language is that it has got no words. There is no question of accent and pronunciation difficulties. There is no dictionary for it, no lexicon, no thesaurus, no encyclopedia of words. Rather, to learn the language of silence, you have to unlearn human languages. Language of silence begins with unlearning languages of words. This is the process of unschooling, undoing, unlearning. Why? We want to enter into this world of silence. Or learn this new fangled language where words are absent. Because the truth cannot be realized with or by words. Because words lead to confusion. Words still keep you grounded. Silence makes you fly. And there's a book, Alice in Wonderland, by Lewis Carroll, where a small girl, Alice, reaches a dream world, a wonderland, a utopia, where everything is magical. And there she meets the queen. The queen asks Alice, "Did you meet anyone coming towards me?" Alice says, "Nobody, madam." So queen thinks nobody is some person. She says, "Nobody." The queen wants to reconfirm it. So the queen asks the messenger, "Did you meet someone coming towards me?" The messenger says, "Nobody, madam." So the queen thinks nobody is a person whom these two people have met. So she says to the messenger, "It's such a long time and you met nobody already. It means that nobody walks slower than you. That's why he's late." But it has got another meaning now. Nobody walks slower than me. So messengers, he's a messenger. He's a postman. They are known for walking faster. He says, "No, madam. Nobody walks faster than me." So queen says, "If nobody walks faster than you, then he should have been here by now." The messenger says, "No, madam, nobody means nobody." Queen says, "Yes, that's what I'm saying. Nobody means nobody." And the confusion goes on. Words lead to confusion. In silence, there is no confusion. Rather, it takes you beyond confusions. They say that silence is the language of gods. A guru is sitting, and there are thousands of disciples. Guru is not speaking a single word, and yet the doubts, the misgivings of disciples are getting dispelled. Gurustumanam vyakhyanam. It is the vyakhyan, it is the speech of silence. Shishyastu chinna sanshaya. And the doubts, and the questions, and the queries of the disciples are getting removed. What is this silence? And when Baba says silence, what does he mean? He is the ocean of silence. When we say silence, we just means absence of sound. But when God uses the word silence, definitely it will not be such a narrow definition. Keeping mum, not speaking, alone is not silence. Definitely silence must be having deeper connotations. This is the divine message of 7th June 2011. Dadi is taking love and remembrance of teachers to the subtle world. And as usual, Baba is showering her with various self-respects, blessings, after initial formalities of the subtle world. Iske baad Baba bole, यह मौन ग्रुप तो अच्छा कर्मेंद्रिय जीत का पार्ट बजा रहा है. There is a silent group. Probably there must be silent retreat going on. बाहर के बोल बोलने के बजाय अंतर्मुखी सदा सुखी का अनुभव कर रहे. Introspective souls are always happy. साइलेंस इज गोल्ड का अनुभव कर अपने में साइलेंस की शक्ति का अनुभव बढ़ा रहे. बाप दादा बच्चों पर खुश है कि अपनी कर्मेंद्रियों की कंट्रोलिंग पावर रूलिंग पावर के अनुभव स्वराज्य अधिकारी स्टेज का अनुभव कर रहे. साइलेंस रिट्रीट from the world of words to enter the world of wordlessness, from the world of noise and sound to enter the world of soundlessness. That speechless world, that noiseless world, that world which is free from all the turbulence of sound. So there is a silent retreat happening. Teachers have come and Baba is addressing them. The more silent one is, the more powerful one becomes. Silence is the manifestation of power. They describe four types of silence. The first, silence of speech. It is known as mon, where one observes, restraining one's speech, not speaking. This is at the physical level, where attempt is made to restrain the organ of speech. The aim of spiritual life is conservation of energy. And most of our energy is dissipated in chit-chatting, in gossiping, in conversing, in speaking, in idle talking, in loose talks, in waste talks, in talks about the past, cheap talks. When somebody takes this as a vrat, as a pledge, as an oath, the effort has to be made not to speak. So that is the first type of silence. Even when one does that, one experience power. That experience of power is because of conservation of energy. One is to speak with human beings, another is to speak with animals, third is to speak with inanimate objects of the nature. Poets speak with river, they speak with stars, they speak with clouds, they speak with wind, sun, the moon, and they feel an intimate connection with them, and they feel it is better to talk with them than to talk with humans. So talking with humans, talking with animals, talking with nature, and then talking with God. Talking with all those beings who don't speak. So silence of speech means you restrain your speech, you don't talk. It is a stage of introspection. You go deep within and scan your own mind, every nook and cranny of your subconscious store. The second is silence of senses. Silence of senses. In yogic terminology, it is known as pratyahar. You restrain and withdraw your senses. This is the fifth pillar of Patanjali's eight-limbed Rajyoga. After practicing postures and breath for a long time, now the aspirant enters into the process of pratyahara, where one learns to restrain the senses. Senses have a tendency to move out, to run after objects. Pratyahara is to become like a tortoise, like a turtle, and go within. Not just the organ of speech, but all the organs, all the senses, which have got outward tendencies. The third is the silence of the statue. Silence of statue. Here the thoughts start becoming one-pointed, concentrated. Even the body starts becoming still. The movement of the body reduces, so also the movement of the mind. Where one reaches or attempts to reach the stage of emotional neutrality, emotional stability, like a statue. You have seen Buddha sitting like this, still, no movement. How long one can sit like that? It is not just about posture, but is also stilling the mind. The fourth is the sleepless silence. The fourth type of silence is sleepless silence. This is also known as Turiya, the fourth. This cannot be described in words, but here the mind becomes so silent that nothing external, no outward influence causes or influences causes any disturbance within. And this is natural stage of the self. These three first stages require effort. This stage is beyond effort. Here, the yogi has reached the highest stage. Just sitting. Good news, bad news, somebody praising, somebody abusing. Nothing affects. There's a very high stage of consciousness. Where the self is situated in the self. The self is absorbed in the self. So there is no turbulence. Baba says silence is gold. Enter into that silence. Stop chit-chatting. That is the wastage of energy. So learn to be silent many times throughout the day. When it is necessary, you speak. But most of the time, you will find that it is unnecessary chatter. Silence is a great power because you experience the stage of self-sovereignty, Swarajya Adhikar, in silence. Time is not wasted. Energy is not wasted. So where will the energy go? Energy will rush up towards the higher chakras, the activation of the higher chakras. Spirituality is all about conservation. Save time. Save speech. Save gastric juices. Save vital fluid, the vital energy. Save. And you will be saved. Yogi is someone who is called Urdhvareta. Urdhvareta means his energies are moving up. It is transcending the lower chakras. Moving up into the heart chakra, throat chakra, third chakra, and entering the highest. And that's why his brain becomes powerful. Because all the lower tendencies have stopped. The dissipation of the energy has stopped. In today's Sakar Murli, Baba said you are very poor or weak in yoga. Why? Because of your physical love. Because of your entrapment in name and form of somebody. So let the energy move up. Let the energy fly up. Go up. The more energy you have, the more powerful you become. The more creative you become. And you develop the power to detach yourself from the body. And all the bondages start in the body. The moment this freedom happens, you enter into a new realm. Till now, we are trying to understand knowledge with our mind. But then understanding with mind ends. It's a stage of no mind. Then you start speaking the language of silence, and God is silence. Two silence meet each other. When two sound meet each other, what happens? Greater sound. Two sounds are meeting each other, what happens? More sound. But what happens when two silence meet each other? More silence. So what will happen if the ocean of silence meets somebody who is an embodiment of silence? The volcano of silence will take place. The earthquakes of Words would cease. Words causes earthquakes. Silence causes cessation of earthquakes. Silence is anti-quake therapy. Anti-shock therapy. Words are shocking. Silence takes you beyond shock. Silence is the shock absorber. It's a buffer. So learn to pause, to enjoy the interval. The interval is always relaxing. Om Shanti.